I have just received the RTNDF Ivanhoe Medical Broadcasting Intern Award. I'm very excited about it. We just got back from Las Vegas. We were at the convention, RTNDA at NAB. And to receive an RTNDA award, at least they make you feel like you're a pretty important person. They're parading you around, introducing you to people. They put a little banner on your name tag that you wear around all week, and it feels good to represent Ohio University and to feel like I have accomplished something just coming out of school here. The internship will start in July and will run through October. And Ivanhoe is kind of a really specialized company in our business because they only do medical stories, consumer stories, women's interest stories, or economic or environmental interest stories. So they're very specialized in the kind of stories that they follow. And then their news is actually syndicated to about 300 stations around the country. So there's a lot of opportunity for exposure, I think, from that angle. And they're based in Orlando, so I'm going to be going there, working for them. They have a very big web presence. I'm going to be doing a lot of writing for the web, as well as putting together television packages that will then be sent out to some of their companies. I think that I was chosen for the internship because they saw potential. I think that's what people are looking for right now with someone coming out of school. The industry is changing so much, and something that all, I think, of the people that are graduating with me this year in 2009 have is a flexibility. We know how to work with different mediums. We're comfortable. We're not afraid of Twitter or Facebook or whatever is going to be the next website that we're going to have to add on to our plates. We're looking forward to a career where we're going to spend time online or on camera or behind the camera or in the edit bay. All of those different places kind of rolled into one. I think maybe the problem in the industry right now is that some of the veterans, some of the people who have great journalistic skills are maybe afraid to tap into some of those other areas of technology, and that's kind of holding them back. And I think that's the opportunity that all of us in my generation have, is to kind of jump in there and say, we grew up with these things, we're comfortable using them, and we're ready to implement them in different ways in the name of journalism. At the EW Scripps School of Journalism, I decided coming in as a freshman that I really wanted to be a broadcast news major. And I wasn't sure whether I would stick with that or not because there were so many other opportunities, but it really was the right fit for me. So I ended up taking the broadcast news track and doing a lot of those courses, as well as doing some online and some multimedia courses at the same time. And then I did a minor in economics to kind of round out the other side of things and get some arts and sciences. I took the business journalism courses offered here, and those, I think, were a huge opportunity for me to learn a lot about something that I didn't really understand going into it. I had an interest there, which I think is necessary because I had always liked economics and always liked math and things like that, but I never wanted to be a business major or take accounting or any of those things. And I think taking the business writing classes actually helped me kind of learn those things through an immersion in them, but actually learned how to cover them at the same time. Because I think sometimes we have a hard time drawing that connection between what I'm learning about supply and demand and how I'm going to write about that in a story that makes sense to the average Joe. And I think that the business writing classes helped me in a big way be able to do that in that specific genre. And I was working at WUB the day of Virginia Tech, and that was a big day on campus here because it kind of took a long time for people to know what was going on. And all of the similarities that were drawn between Ohio University and Virginia Tech after the fact, the similarities of the campus, the size, those sorts of things, kind of gave people a connection to Virginia Tech, even if they didn't know someone there. So it was really important, I think, to be out on campus that day and talking to people and doing, you know, MOS, man on the street, just getting people's reactions to something that people weren't really thinking about, I don't think, on a college campus at that point. I would say another highlight was this year when I completed a story for Journalism 464, which is our long-form documentary class in the broadcast news track. We saw this story in the USA Today about the smokestack effect, and they ranked schools in terms of air quality around the nation. And there were a couple people in the community that were really upset because there were a lot of schools in our region that were listed in the first percentile as far as worst schools in the nation, and there weren't being a lot of answers given as to whether this study, which was independently done by the USA Today, had a lot of fact to it, whether it was something to be concerned about, or whether that was something that was everybody already knew. And so we kind of tried to address some of those questions and talk to the EPA and talk to some of the schools in the Marietta region, in the Racine, Ohio region, and get some answers for them. And I think the final product really turned out to help people deal with the results they had just seen. Ultimately, I would just recommend for every student to be very well-rounded. I think that you need to have a comfortable base in a lot of different kinds of issues, whether it's government or the economy is going to be a big factor for the next couple years. And I think that feeling comfortable talking about any of those things is a big asset to anyone.